And I don't know why. Counting the cars on the New Jersey Turnpike, we've all come to look for a
Thank you. There's a time, and the time is now, and it's right for me. It's right for me, and the time is now. There's a word, and the word is love, and it's right for me. It's right for me, and the word is love. There's a time, and the time is now, and it's right for me. It's right for me, and the time is now. There's a word, and the word is love, and it's right for me. It's right for me, and the word is
from learning new languages. Translate each word as it brings your creation. Your voice is the perfect key. Is there something that I'm supposed to see? Is there something that I'm supposed to feel? I'm with you, and I can't help but want to know.
Talk to me.
Is there something that I'm supposed to teach? Is there something that I'm supposed to find as I reach to the healing of His spoken word? Some strange reason I just cannot wait a minute. I'm chasing every second before I let go. Yesterday, my history, my dreams are still a mystery. This living is a gift I should know. Lay down and let me live the new language. Let me learn at every twist, every turn. Lay down and let me love the further future. Let me know I'm coming. Let me know I'm learning. Let me know I'm moving on. Vision is racing so fast, I can't help myself. Chasing this reason to the wrong kinds of reasoning. People embracing these feelings of limbo, just wasting the real world away. Taking a chance as it comes, only once, only friends can do justice with words of new languages. Translate creation as they bring you salvation. Your voice is the perfect key. Is there something that I'm supposed to see? Is there something that I'm supposed to feel? I'm with you, and I can't help but want to know. Is there something that I'm supposed to teach? Is there something that I'm supposed to find as I reach to the healing of His spoken word?
Thank you. Muchas gracias. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. That's a song called New Languages from The Ladder. And sunshine is creeping in, and in a field a life begins. Survival, survival, they take away and they give. Okay.
First of all, welcome to Argentina once again, and I would love to have your idea about this new album, The Ladder, which I think it is one of the best Yes albums in your whole, in your 30 years, 30 years. Career, really.
We're Thank very you. Glad you think that, and we enjoyed making it.
You've got to be much closer to the mic.
You can do it.
Like this?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Hi. Yeah, we're very glad you liked the new album, and we enjoyed making it. We made it very much as a live album in the studio, everyone playing together. We kept a lot of the backing tracks from guitars and keyboards as well as drums and bass, and it has a very good live group feeling on the album. And any other comments?
Well, I think after so many years, you know, to make an album where we were together in rehearsal, mm-hmm. and then in the studio, and at least we were very happy to be together. Mm-hmm. We'd already been on the road for a year, touring, mm-hmm. so it was a good feeling to make this album.
Is there any comment, Steve, or are you agree? Do you subscribe to that point of view?
I don't think we need three answers to every question. I can't. By the time you two have answered it, I'm not.
Is it hard to still find the magic after 30 years? Being together, gathering and composing and writing music and playing?
The more you look for it, the less it's there, you know. I mean, you've got to let it just happen, you know. So if you ask us to find the magic, I don't know where it comes from. But it comes from us, you know, I mean, isn't magic so much as a energy that we get together. So it's hard if we don't go about things in the right way and, you know, we don't keep a nice balance. So the more we get things right, then the better the music is. Mm-hmm. So I suppose that's what makes, if there is magic, then it makes it come back, because we're enjoying ourselves and, you know, we had good direction and from Bruce Fairbairn. So basically, you know, you just need to get some things right before you can get really important things right.
Mm-hmm. What about, because besides your solo efforts, Chris, you two guys have been doing solo stuff with other people, playing with some other groups, in the case of GTR, Asia, well, your solo stuff, your numerous kind of, you know, albums. Was it good for the unity of the group, or at some points it was hard after doing solo projects to get back together, living besides the egos that we all have, and particularly the business
end? You know, John is a workaholic. He loves to just, you know, he'll put an album out every month if you let him. So that's good for him. Me, I'm really slow, very lazy. It's taken me 30 years to make a second solo album. I haven't done it yet, so, you know. We were...
Earlier, John said that it's, you know, he was asked this question earlier from somebody, and John was saying that there's lots of room, there's lots of music for us to do, and since Yes has a central role in our lives, then it's kind of good to release the frustration that you might have if you couldn't, say, get that batch of songs out or get those instrumentals out. If you tried to put them all into Yes, there would be no room, you know, mm-hmm. for other people's ingredients. So maybe for John and I in particular, it's quite good for us to kind of keep that greased, because it certainly, I don't think it detracts from Yes, because what Yes wants from me and what Yes wants from John is not necessarily what we put on our solo records.
Mm-hmm. Once I heard you, John, talking about the lack of inspiration in the 90s and the lack of personality that you have in the 60s and the 70s. You were, you know, for one particular style, and you try to explore, to experiment, and probably nowadays there are much people trying to copy the people that really succeed. What do you think about, in terms of music, what is going on today?
Well, if you think about the history of the music of the last 30 years, 40 mm-hmm. years, really, mm-hmm. you have these very standout people, Jimi Hendrix and bands like The Who, mm-hmm. and these artists that had great momentum. Mm-hmm. It's the video world, but I think I was talking about how the video music or video music became so popular, mm-hmm. it didn't sustain the musicianship. Mm-hmm. But I still believe there are some very talented musicians around, and I think into the next 10 years, this is when we will hear some of the great music that's available, because there's a lot of young musicians out there wanting just to make music, but they're being told all the time to be a top 10 group or mm-hmm. pop group or stick to making money group, mm-hmm. and really this destroys a young musician, and he feels like, I just want to make music, I don't want to be told by the big record companies that my music isn't mm-hmm. hip or isn't commercial enough, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. and I think the time is coming where younger musicians are going to be able to experiment more, and that's because of the internet development, mm-hmm. basically. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Who are the artists or the groups or which is the music that really touches you nowadays?
I was saying before that Alanis Morissette, mm-hmm. great songwriter, and Bella Fleck, I love the band, they've been around mm-hmm. quite a long time, I'm sure.
Yeah, it's interesting you should say that, because to follow on from what John is saying, there are some outlets for some people, like Marilyn Manson. Mm-hmm. I guess he's doing what he wants to do. He wants to be Alice Cooper number the second, and you know, and it's kind of working for him. So I suppose, you know, like, and there are bands out there like Fish, you know, who play, you know, three nights in Madison Square Garden, mm-hmm. and yet you don't see their records in the charts.
Mm-hmm, that's
so,
right.
So, you know, mm-hmm. So I think it's still possible for bands to get a following from, you know, from an audience without having to obey the rules, mm-hmm. but it's difficult, as John says.
What are your choices, Tim?
Well, I hate this question because music isn't...
Sorry.
I mean, there's always new music coming out. But what I hate about it is it puts you in a position to try and, like, pinpoint things. When I'm still discovering music from the 40s or 50s, I don't go out of my way to constantly stick with finding music that's just come out from this generation. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. But there's a lot of music that inspired me, particularly hillbilly guitar playing, that inspired me. So, you know, I don't need the charts. You know, mm-hmm. what I need is to find out more about maybe, you know, some of the great composers, some of the great musicians and artists of this century.
Actually, like you made a tribute to Bob Dylan, for example.
I've recently done an album of Bob Dylan songs, mm-hmm. because, you know, there are these people who I still need to reevaluate, mm-hmm. reexamine. So I'm not always looking for the new blood so much, mm-hmm. as that mm-hmm. filters through to me, mm-hmm. through my children and through the natural course of listening to radio and seeing MTV and Much Music and all the other programs. But definitely there's still more music to discover. Say we just come from Brazil and I heard somebody playing Vila Lobos in Brazil, mm-hmm. and it really meant a lot to me, mm-hmm. so I keep looking at the great musicianship of this century, mm-hmm. not just this year, mm-hmm. this year mm-hmm. is incidental, mm-hmm. compared mm-hmm. to the other 98.